it. And we don't need a doctor's note to run away from it. And when we're scared, we can't tell our parents, we can't tell our best friends, 'cause we're too embarrassed. You're having teeth dreams again. You're having teeth dreams again. And we're scared that if we can make ourselves stop crying, then it's all fake. What the fuck does that make us then? Are we being bad friends? Are we playing pretentious for the attention? Mammalian diving reflex, cold water on your face. Then the perfect little moment when your best friends say,
if you just grow up, then you wouldn't feel this way.
Are the things that we thought we felt so felt by everybody else? Are we feeling sorry for ourselves? Let's help personal creations, cinematic projection of our own imaginations on a wall. We're all twisted up, tangled and trenched, and completely fucked in the question. It's a brittle invention. Question, what's a brittle invention? You're on death row now at San Quentin, and I've got your CDC. Repressed memories, and she'd be 21 if it wasn't for you. David Westerfield, your mama said you're a monster. I could write you, but do I want to? I could write you. Do I want to? I could write you. Do I want to? And we're wondering if we're just imitating emotions from dramatic fictions. Neurodivergence is commodity. Reenacting the vehemence found in movies and television. We will never not be heard enough, but we will never not be scared enough to feel broken, torn, and cracked, and ask for help and scurry back to hide away in the same place that we have always run to. We need the attention. God bless every laptop, every internet computer.